Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO of DVC Technology, and I've got a cool one today. Today we're going to review the new Unifi Superlink. Like a lot of you, I've been using Unifi Smart sensors at my house for a while now, and some of the new 7 line of WAPs do not support those sensors anymore. So I've been wondering, what's the long-term strategy for Unifi here with these types of smart sensors and IoT devices? And I'm super happy to see that not only are they not orphaning those devices or making those devices only work on older gear, but they are developing this into a whole new ecosystem. So we're going to go through that today. I'm going to do a quick install of the Superlink. I'm going to show you how it works on the existing smart sensors. I do not have any of the new Superlink clients, but we'll go through what those look like. They've teased a little image with some possible sensors that may be coming out later this year, and we'll discuss where I think the Superlink technology is heading in the future. So let's jump right into it. This has your typical nice Unifi packaging that we all come to expect. It's a small little device. It has an antenna on it. It says an RJ45 connector for PoE Ethernet and a little reset button on it. So on the store, it calls this a proprietary, super long range, low latency wireless gateway for Unifi Protect sensors. It will support up to 96 Superlink clients. Obviously, those aren't out yet, but those will have a range up to 2 kilometers away. That's line of sight, so obviously, if you have anything in between there, it's going to diminish that distance. It also has support for 7 UpSense BLE devices with improved long-range connectivity. I have 2 smart sensors on it right now, and I'll go through that long-range connectivity. I think they're being pretty conservative on the distances that they're estimating. And you can power it, as I mentioned, either with PoE or with an optional USB Type-C charger. It also includes wall and DIN rail mount options. Those are really nice. You can mount them and there's a little track that the unit just slides right on. Really easy install. Unifi was super nice to send over a demo Superlink. They also included a little marketing blurb. I'll read that now. As Unifi's physical security platform continues to evolve, we are thrilled to introduce a sneak peek at our upcoming lineup of advanced sensors and IoT devices. These new additions are designed to specifically enhance the platform's capabilities, providing greater security, smarter insights, and seamless integration. At the heart of this innovation is our all-new, groundbreaking wireless protocol, Superlink. Purpose-built to perform seamlessly in both smart home settings and demanding industrial environments, Superlink delivers unmatched versatility with ultra-low latency, exceptional battery efficiency, great scalability, and an incredible multi-kilometer range. It sets a new standard for security and reliable IoT connectivity. While Superlink endpoint devices are set to launch later this year, we are excited to announce the Superlink Gateway is available today, featuring additional integrated long-range Bluetooth low-energy capabilities to fully support first-generation Protect BLE multi-sensor deployments. That's really cool. I took 2 things away from that. One, that they're going to have ongoing support for the existing smart sensors out there and a path forward on being able to deploy those now that newer WAPs don't have support for that BLE technology. The second part and really exciting part is that they're coming out with these new sensors. And in Unifi's press release video, they teased a bunch of these new sensors. Now, I don't have any insider information here, but from that video, I could see an environmental sensor that I'm really interested in there, an alarm sensor, a siren, glass breaking sensors, door sensors, motion sensors, air quality sensors. So those are all really cool sensors, and I've got some thoughts on all of them. But let's jump into the software real quick. Let's get the Superlink adopted. I'm going to test the range on a couple of smart sensors, and then we'll take a look at how they work with Alarm Manager. All right, let's jump into Protect real quick, and let's get this guy adopted. So, all right, you can see it already popped up here. I'm going to click OK to adopt it. And you can see it also sees the other sensor there. I'm going to let it do its thing there for a second. All right, that was quick and super easy. Here it is showing up here, Superlink US. It shows status, connections excellent, Superlink US 1.3.3, basic stuff. And under settings, I can rename it. I can have the LED to always on or always off. I can click locate, restart, and remove. Really not much to it as a device. Pretty simple and pretty easy to adopt. With that being adopted, I'm going to go ahead and click on the smart sensor here, and now it's adopting, showing that it's on Bluetooth, and that one device has been added. And for those of you who haven't seen a smart sensor before, there is this thing called Sensor Manager. I'll go here in a second to it. It's going to show you its status. It's a connection. So obviously, where we put this in the rack right by the Superlink, it's going to obviously have an excellent connection, but we will add in a second one here and test that distance out a little bit. Bad activities, there's no activity yet. And under settings here, we can change the name. Here, I'm going to call this rack because this one is in the rack. And there's no paired camera, but I can pair a camera. That's pretty cool. I will pair Not Clay, which is right above it. And status light, dashboard widget. On both of those, we can create tags. We can show events to capture here. So I'm going to capture temperature, humidity, light, open, close. Same with motion. I don't necessarily need motion there because I have cameras around it. So I'm going to do open, close, light, humidity, and temperature here. Also has option for water leak if you have that case, and audio alarm. For these legacy sensors here, you know, you are balancing a little bit with battery life versus the number of events that you capture. You can go right into Alarm Manager and you can manage your alarms here. You can also manage your connection settings. So I have a E6 office WAP here. I could switch to that when I'm going to leave it on the Superlink. And I could lock into this device, which I'm going to. And I'm going to go ahead and go apply changes. So that's all set. Oh, now you can see that it's paired with that camera. I'm going to go in here into Sensor Manager. And this is where you're going to get output from that Sensor Manager. And I can click here and do those sensor settings right here if I wanted to add that motion or change whatever here. And what you'll see over time here is that this is going to create a graph where I can see during the day what my temperature, what my humidity, what my light settings look like. I can also, if I want to go into Alarm Manager, I can go click Alarm, and I can go Extreme Value on the sensors, which is probably a cool one. So if I just want to do that, I can go to Notify, and it'll notify me. And I could also on the sensors go low battery, open status change, close status change. So for that rack, so for the one that I did on the rack here, I will put open status changed. Obviously, if somebody opens the rack now, it's going to notify me. The one last thing I needed to do was to click on the sensor, and I changed the name to Smart Sensor here, and I will click Create. And now you'll see I will get notified whenever that happens. Pretty cool stuff. You can see now that rack sensor is updating to the latest, greatest firmware there. All right, well, actually, it's a day later. I ran out of time yesterday, which is kind of good because now I have some data on that first sensor. So if you go ahead and click on the sensor and I go to Sensor Manager now, I've got a day's worth of data on that. And you can see kind of what that looks like. Really cool stuff. You can see the lights went off at a little after 5 p.m. They didn't come on until 6 a.m. Pretty cool, humidity, all that stuff. You would get days and days of that. And you can see that I also have added the second sensor. On the second sensor, I've kind of played around with where I would put it in the office. You can see that the link condition on this one is good, whereas the link condition on the first one in the rack that's right by the Superlink is an excellent, and this one's just a good. And I will show you on Design Center why that is. So the rack is over here. This is not an accurate depiction of the equipment that's in my room, that's in my office anymore, but this is a map of our office. If I go into the draw cable here, this is the distance that the sensor is away from the rack where it is right now. So it's 87. I tried it all the way in this corner as well. It was fine as well at that distance. So this is the where I actually am going to leave it for long term. I ultimately will probably put the Superlink right here in the middle of the office, which is going to give me coverage on the entire office. But it also has construction where there's not a ton of walls in between here and there. There's quite a few at this angle, but you know, it's in a house, there may be more than that, so your mileage may vary. Also, just it did the update from 1.0 to 1.25 in its current position. So, you know, pushing more data like a firmware update, it was totally fine at that distance as well. You can see I did that about an hour ago. It's doing just fine there. It is finding activities there. I have this one set for temperature, humidity, light, and motion. This is our YouTube studio. People don't normally go in there. So I threw in a motion detection there just to see what that looks like. I also, just for my testing, I did lock this device to the Superlink because we do have another access point in this office, this U6 office WAP that it could jump over to. And I wanted to force it to stay on that one just for my testing. So anyways, that was super quick and easy to get this configured. Now I can just go into Sensor Manager over here, check them anytime, set up more alarms. I actually set up another alarm for the YouTube room. I'm going here and show you that it is a low battery in motion for that. And it's just set to notify me. So pretty simple, pretty easy. And with that, let's jump into a couple FAQs before I get to who I think this device is really for. How many Superlink devices can be connected to one console? There's no limit to the number of Superlink devices used. So you could put multiple of these in your deployment. There is no limit to that. Can I use Superlink alongside existing Bluetooth enabled U6 access points? Yes, UPSense BLE units will automatically connect to the Bluetooth gateway with the strongest signal. Sensors can also be locked to specific gateways in device settings. Yeah, you saw me go through that there. I actually have a U6 access point that it could jump to, and I locked it there, but it will automatically find the one that has the strongest signal and connect to that. Where can I install Superlink for the best coverage? For optical range, mount Superlink high on a wall or on a DIN rail in a central location, minimizing obstructions between the gateway and your sensors. ultimately, I'm just going to put mine high on the wall here in the middle of the office. I would do as I did here, just test it in your location and kind of put your sensors where they're going to be. Don't final mount it. Make sure everything gets good coverage, and then you can permanently mount it. Pretty simple to do. What is the range of Superlink's sub-G connectivity? Superlink can communicate with the upcoming Superlink sensors up to 2 kilometers line of sight. Actual performance may vary based on environmental factors such as obstacles and local RF conditions. Yeah, 2 kilometers is a super long way. I don't have anything to test that right now, but I'm super interested to do that when those come out. So that being said, who do I think this is for? First off, I think anybody that's already using these smart sensors, this is going to decrease your reliability on those U6 WAPs to control this, so kind of future-proofing you. The added range is nice. This definitely goes further than the U6 WAPs did. So those people that already have nice sensors, I think this is kind of nice to upgrade that existing system and to future-proof you so that when you go to those U7 WAPs, you don't have any issues. Yeah, you know, as I look at the new sensors in kind of the broader picture of those IoT devices, I think this is a great first step into that ecosystem. I think a lot of those sensors that they mentioned there, for me at my house, we live in a high rise. There are water leaks from time to time. Having an additional leak sensor, the air quality sensor, the smoke detector sensor, those are all ones that I have an eye on for my house itself. But the bigger opportunity for me personally is as an MSP. We put Protect systems in commercially. For us, I think this can expand on what their current systems are doing. So we do a lot of dental offices. Dental offices are prone to flooding. They have a lot of plumbing in the office that goes to the chairs and the delivery units. And if any of those fittings ever break overnight, the office will flood. So for us, inexpensive leak sensors could be awesome for our clients that already have Protect in their office and just wanted an added layer of security there. Also, for internal doors and windows that you want monitoring on, that you don't necessarily want the alarm company to alert the police on, but you want to know, did somebody go in this room at this certain time? Those are awesome features. We also do warehouses and light industrial, and to be able to monitor certain pieces of equipment for temperature and humidity and air quality, those kind of things. I can see this as a low-cost way with low maintenance to do really high-end monitoring of those devices. Another cool thing about these sensors is because they use so little power, you can leave them out there for a long, long time. We're talking years sometimes between battery placements. It means they're low maintenance, and they alert you when they do need the battery replacement. So I think these can be really great additions to a lot of those businesses. Also, I don't know what the relay and hub were for there, but I can see at some point that maybe these are able to be connected into your existing security system, meaning you could use the monitoring services you're already paying for to, you know, have additional alerting. I'm not sure how that would work, and I have no intel into that at all. But you can see, you know, your mind starts spinning here on what the possibilities are. Also, with the power of the alarm manager now and the way you're able to get these alerts and the way they're building that out, there's all these if-then kind of scenarios that you can do, different things you can notify, different ways you can notify things. You can also integrate it into third-party applications. You can see how this can build and kind of the possibilities be endless. So for me personally, I'm super excited about this. I'm going to leave this one deployed in my business. I will get a second one for my home. I do also plan on putting this in my clients' offices. But please let me know what questions you have by putting them down below. I answer all of those. Please like and subscribe. And as always, we'll see you guys in the next video.